Who wants to start us off?
Coach, I'm not going to ask you to rehash Saturday. It looked pretty darn good from where I was sitting. But let's flip to this weekend. And I'm not trying to compare teams or anything, but Arkansas's secondary got lit up pretty well against Alabama.
Yeah, Arkansas will be a change of pace with what we just played, But, you know, we're in there watching them right now. Their front seven is pretty good, football team. I think they're definitely better than their record. 90-3, 8-23 all stand out to us. Haven't evaluated the secondary yet, so I don't have some tidbits on that yet. That's coming up. But you know, we've got our hands cut out. You know, our hands full. I think going away probably not a bad thing. I think we traveled well. I'm looking forward to this trip. I just want to see us continue playing consistently. I'm really, as I said Saturday, excited about the decision-making part of this whole thing. And I also like that Coach Luke emphasized playing consistently, and I thought that's what they gave him on Saturday.
Hey, Phil, from what you have seen of Arkansas so far athletically, how do they compare to LSU and Alabama?
Oh, they're a little different. I think like the players I named, 90-23 and 8, number 3, they stand out to me. I don't know maybe if they're as deep as the two teams that you mentioned. I think that's the biggest difference is the depth. You know, I think when the twos come out for Arkansas, it's not the same maybe right now as when the twos come out for Alabama and LSU.
Jordan, you know, had some nice runs against ULM. Was that a goal to get him more involved in the run game, or was that just what he saw?
It's really just what they gave. And, you know, they gave up the draw. We thought the draw was going to be a good play. Linebackers got a lot of depth in the pass game, so it gave us a lot of distance between the RB and the release lineman in the draw, so it just became a good play for us. You know, the keep outside on the lead play by Jordan was just a good, smart pull, you know, one that he missed earlier in the season. And the same thing with Matt Corral. I mean, he pulled one on a counter play, and, you know, what he said was he's probably about 15, 20 yards down the field, and he thought he was going to get ready to go out of bounds, and he realized he could beat the last defender, and so he just tried to kick it in gear, and he got by him, and, you know, next thing you know, he's down the sideline. So he made some good decisions. A lot of those were good decisions, you know what I mean? Those are, you know, we had a throw off the draw and went there, and he took it, ran it when he was supposed to, and, you know, it wound up being a positive play.
Questions?
In terms of decision making, I know once against Alabama and some against LSU, when Jordan had less time, those were harder, you had a little more trouble. Do you see this as a step forward, or is it just because of the defenses that you're facing?
Actually, I do see it as a step forward because a lot of those decisions are pre-snap. You know, post-snap, we kind of know where we're going. It's that time in the twilight zone between them getting the signal and them running the play that they have to assimilate some information and make a good decision about where they want to go. And so regardless of opponent, it's the decision making before the snap that I thought could be more consistent, and it was on Saturday. And we have to continue to game plan with that in mind, and we have to continue to focus on it at the quarterback position. I think if we do that, then we should get what we need to get out of the offense.
What did you see from Matt Corral Saturday? The positives, negatives, just everything.
I have to smile when you bring up that. He's extremely aggressive, and so you kind of, like I said this before, you kind of have to corral a little bit. I mean, he's a fighter. He's a competitor. What I really, really liked was the fact that he made very quick decisions. Even when he made a couple wrong ones, he made them really, really fast. They were really aggressive. one of them actually became a positive play because of how quickly he dished the ball out. And I think the sky's the limit for Matt as he keeps developing. Not that this was a negative recruiting him, but no one really brought up how intelligent he is when we were recruiting him. You know, it was never a negative, but it just wasn't something that people pointed out. But I think he's extremely intelligent. He sees the big picture. He sees the game. And if he stays locked in and focused, I think that's going to be a strong point for him outside of just the big arm and the mobility.
Are there any more questions for Coach Longley?